We are live.
Good afternoon to one and all. Good afternoon, Principal Sir, who will be joining us later on. He is in a meeting. Good afternoon, Dhoni Ma'am. Today is our speaker. Good afternoon, Ahuti Ma'am, Media Club, and to all the students who are eagerly awaiting for this session on process of communication, which is the very first chapter that comes. But apart from that, this is one of the most important topics into every man's life. Because communication is what is required. People say that there are lists of miscommunication or lots of ways that we miscommunicate. So here we have arranged a session on communication wherein ma'am will be discussing upon different aspects, the process, and each and everything. Without wasting much of time, we are already running short of time. I would request Ahuti ma'am to share her kind words, and then ma'am, it's all your show.
Thank you, sir. Yes, sir, dear students, understanding the process of communication is very, very fundamental when we want to develop our communication skills, soft skills, and largely speaking, our life skills as well as personality development also. Communication is not something that we do at some particular point of time in our life for some particular period. In a larger context, communication occupies whole of our life. And that is why in communication classes, it is often stated that the communication is a sum total of all human activities. And that is why it is very essential for us to clear our basic understanding about the nature of communication and how its process exactly takes place. Today, we shall learn that with Dr. Dhoni Vaishnav Madam. I warmly welcome her to be the resource person of this online lecture series. And we both have shared several training programs and workshops also together. So it's my privilege to welcome Madam. And yes, have a nice session ahead, Madam.
Thank you, Madam.
Ma'am is from Shantilal Shah Engineering College. So it's like, you know, a Bhavnagar ma'am coming to Bhavnagar only to teach the students, the extended students, we can say, right? A sister, yes. Concerned, extended, yes, a bache, extended family member. Dhoni ma'am is like extended family member of GC Bhavnagar. We can say that because we all, you know, hum log kya aage ka tag alag hai, but Bhavnagar common hai. So, ma'am. We welcome you, and
thank you, sir.
I know that you are a fabulous teacher and famous among students, and you are famous to my students also. They know you as a youth festival coordinator and all. So people were eagerly waiting the moment they saw the poster. Kya baat hai? So please, ma'am, it's all your show.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. At the outset, I would like to thank, as a part of my duty, Professor Himanshu Srivastav and Ahuti ma'am also for pursuing me for this talk. Somehow it was not happening last time when sir had invited me for the first phase of this online lecture series. But this time finally, yes, we could make it. And I'm happy to be around with you right now, of course, through this digital medium. But we hope that we would soon be able to meet in person and the campuses would be shared. It has always been a pleasure to be with all your faculties and student friends. So without much ado, I would quickly just share my screen. Before that, let me just give a brief about this. I would not be stretching too long because it's important topic, but it should not be the case that we hamper you so much that at the end you feel that we don't want to communicate now. We are tired of speaking or thinking, right? So as ma'am rightly mentioned, it is one of the most essential skills, or it is one of the most essential activity that we do, consciously or unconsciously. That is first thing. Because even if we don't speak, we speak a lot many things, even if we just move our eyes. And that's why probably sir asked me that, ma'am, please turn on your camera. So without me speaking anything, probably all of you who are watching me through YouTube or by any other medium of social media, you would have been able to identify through my gestures, through my facial expressions, that there is something going on in my mind, or I might be thinking of something. So even if we don't speak, we speak. And at times it is said that a person is known by the words he or she chooses. But at the same time, there is another saying that you present yourself before you speak. So maybe by my looks, maybe by my posture right now, you might assume something, and you would later on learn that a wrong assumption can make differences in communication. So basically, it's a kind of subject which is given you, which is given to you for making your self and personality better. And we would be speaking in context of the professional setup, why we have to learn communication skills. And to learn communication skills, why the process is important. Because we speak every day a lot of things. We think every day a lot of things. We don't speak. We just keep them in our minds, a lot of things. There is a famous poem like, "If Ever I Could Tell You." So from the title itself, you can imagine that there were many intrapersonal communicational thoughts in the poet's mind, but the person never made it public. So that's how we have so many things to think about, to churn about, but we don't speak, we don't communicate. And that's why I'm limiting my scope, that we would be speaking with reference to the professional communication or the technical communication that BE students, third semester or second year students, are supposed to learn, just to give them better exposure to that. Otherwise, communication is lifelong activity and journey. So let me just share my screen. Yes, I just make it full screen. Okay, so this is what we are going to discuss. And if you can see here, I hope that this is not too blurred to see. There are so many words written here randomly: non-verbal, business, listening, master, effective, body language, well, good, message. So when all these things come together, it is known as communication process. And you can see that non-verbal is also a little bit of smaller part of this. Business is also part of it. That means we are discussing this particular aspect in business setup or professional setup also. And for all of us, those who are professionals or those who want to get into any profession, be it your job, be it your own profession, where you are going to be the boss and going to order people, but you will have to communicate. And let me share with you what I keep telling my students also, that even if you are relaxed, that you don't want to move out of Gujarat, you would have to communicate. And to add further to that, you will have to use English communication, because it is expected from you, since you have got the degree from professional course. So it is expected from you that you would be a bit professional. And that is why your teacher, Professor Sir, is taking so much of pain to invite so many various experts from different field, and you know, for the subject. And even he is in charge of finishing school, which I know. So for those students who are final year, who are passing out, for them also he is doing quite a bit of hard work, so that you know, you students can be brushed up, you students can be groomed well, and you can be excellent communicators, because you would be communicating, you would be representing your institute also. So it's not so that you move out of GEC Bhavnagar and then, I don't know, to be an alumni, to be an alumnus of such an institute is also to be proud. So if you observe here, it is saying that it is communication skills. So it's a set of skills. It is not an individual activity that we are doing. It is always communication skills. Earlier, there used to be a paper which was simply called communication skills. So then also it was a bunch of skills that we were expected. Now, coming to our main point, what is communication? By now, I suppose you would have, those students who are semester three, they would have got this chapter, they would have started with this unit, and they would have been probably through also. But basically, communication without dictionary meaning, we might mean to talk. Right? Simply, we don't use any dictionary. It may simply be to talk to somebody, that is. But if we go to the root word, because since we are the students of language, we should always have this habit of going to the root word, to the main form of the verb. So this is derived from Latin language. The word is communicare. Right? You must have learned phonetics, so it should be communicare. And it simply means to share or exchange information, knowledge, and thoughts. So in a day, you would have number of information. You just rotate your eyes, you just go on a street, and you would have n number of advertisements, n number of hoardings. They are all uninvited information, out of which something might be really useful. Every day, thousands of messages are dropped, are wasted as a forwarded message on your WhatsApp, and you all are using Instagram and Facebook and whatnot, Snapchat and so many things. I might even not be knowing few names. Right? So there are number of information pouring in. So that is one information, because everybody thinks that I am communicating information to the other. It might be helpful. Then knowledge. So now let us decide that this is something serious business, knowledge sharing, right? And thoughts. I would like to add ideas also to this list, because the moment you have germination of idea in your mind, you would like to speak to somebody. You would like to share it with somebody. So you are sharing, you are communicating. But what we are trying to do is, we are trying to speak our mind. And don't forget this word, it says exchange. Right? It is not only sharing, it is not only saying. So it is like our regular classes, I suppose it might be the same at your end also. It is not a one-way process. Right? Initially, I had planned that let me have a kind of classroom feel. But then I thought that no, you would be suffering enough. So I should not invite your nemesis today at least. You can read here also. See, to pass on information, news or thoughts. To spread to another or others. So this is how this process starts. This is how we like to, you know, bring people in with our information, knowledge, and thoughts. At the same time, they also pour in. The moment we share, they would always have something or the other to say. Right? તમે કોઈકને એવું કહેજો કે તમને ખબર છે આજ તમારી સાથે આવું થયું, લે હવે એમાં શું. ધ નેક્સ્ટ ઇમિડિયેટ રિસ્પોન્સ વુડ બી, લે એમાં શું, આવું તમારા ઓલા છે ને, ઓલા ઓલા સગા એની સાથે આવું થયું, અરે પરમ દિવસે જ મારી યાર આવું થયું. સો એવરીબડી વુડ હેવ સમથિંગ ઓર ધી અધર ટુ શેર વિથ અસ, રાઈટ? બટ વી હેવ ટુ ડિસાઈડ વેધર ઇટ્સ અ મીનિંગફુલ શેરિંગ ઓર ઇટ્સ જસ્ટ અ ફોરવર્ડ, રાઈટ? ઓકે, નાઉ ધીઝ આર ધ બેઝિક્સ. I really believe that this is a very, very simple, basic attempt to share what I have understood or what I have been learning in this process. Now, this is, you can see that there are dialogue box of different types. See, right? Here, there are not many thoughts as we can see. So what is the entire process about? It requires two parties. This is basic, sender and receiver, right? So right now, consider me as your sender, a person who is trying to share, a person who is trying to send you some message. Now, message should not be limited to your WhatsApp message or SMS message or any other social media message. Information, let us call it information, right? And another person is the receiver. It requires the other party, which is called receiver, who is ready with the bowl to receive the poured in information, that okay, aane do, hum dekh lete hain. Right? So it requires two parties, sender and receiver. Another important point for this is it needs mutually accepted code of symbols. Now, when we say mutually code of symbols, what do we mean? We mean we must have some kind of accepted gesture, posture, expressions where we are coming together on one page, or it requires common code of language. Now, I would like to come back to meeting. I'll stop presenting for a minute. And if somebody is there at my doorstep, out of my room, and if somebody says, "May I come in, ma'am?" I would move my hand like this, or I would say like this, because I'm speaking to you right now. So I cannot interrupt this speaking. So when I say common code of symbols, what we mean is through this, the person understands that, yes, I'm allowing to come. Or through this, I'm saying, yes, you can come in. So this means commonly it is accepted that this particular node means yes. Right? When I entered at that time, if I have said like this, it might have meant hello or hi. But at 5 o'clock, then I would say, okay. I am not saying bye, goodbye, see you. I'm just saying, okay. It would mean I am saying goodbye, see you soon. So this is commonly accepted code of symbols. And with the language, if I say yes, I would just say yes. Ma'am, may I come in? I would say yes. So the person would understand that I am saying yes for taking entry into my room. Right? So, like, depending on the cultures, depending on situations, every time code of symbols change. Like, we say namaste for greetings. In other Western countries, they have a hug, they have handshake. In countries like Japan, they bow down. So we are not shocked when we see them that they are bowing down. And our prime minister or other people who are visiting them, they probably follow their culture. When they come here, they probably follow our culture. And they follow our style of greeting. Right? So at that time, they are not international delegates. They are following the local culture for greeting. So which is a commonly accepted code of symbols. I'm again sharing my screen. I just wanted to show how this works. Yeah. Then types of communication, which is world famous, that it is verbal and non-verbal. Verbal is the one where we are using words whenever we write or when we speak. So if I send a message that I'll be joining late for 5 minutes, that's a verbal message. If I just say, I just note that, so that would be non-verbal communication. I'm indicating you that please give me 5 minutes, right? So that is how this thing happened. And as I told you in the beginning, even if we don't speak, we are speaking every minute. Even blinking of our eyes speak a lot. So people who have been studying or who have been observing people, they might be aware about this fact. And communication plays significant role in any organizational setup. Like, without communication, it's a key to success. It is a very famous quote or a famous sentence that communication is the key for success. Yes, without speaking, without presenting yourself, representing yourself properly, I don't think you can work or you can present yourself effectively. And that's why an adjective, effective technical communication, is added to your name of the subject. Otherwise, it could have been technical communication. Why do you need effective word? Because we are meant to teach you communication skill that you already have, how we have to make it effective, right? Going to another part, yes, I don't think there are students live who can interact with me, but I would like to show a few images.
But they would be, you just show them, give a pause, they will be mentioning it on YouTube so that I can be a connecting link, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Yeah, so I'm just sharing a few images. And if you can imagine, what do they try to communicate?
And students, what these images they try to communicate, what ma'am is sharing, please mention in the comment box of live chat of YouTube. I would be responding on your behalf with your name.
Yeah.
Ma'am.
I'm just moving them fast first and then I'll again show it. Right?
Okay, so don't worry.
So this is the first one.
Okay, students, what does this image communicate to you? Mention first. The image on the screen, what does it communicate to you? Mention fast in the comment box.
This is the second one.
Anyone, if you can come up with.
Yeah, anyone. Yeah, absolutely. You can, you are free to respond to any one of them. Next one.
A student wrote Mirabai with dumbbells.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, we were here. And this is the last one.
Yeah, this one somebody wrote over here, Mirabai with dumbbells. I don't
know. Okay.
मतलब वो डंबल से स्पेलिंग ऐसा है बट ठीक है वो कम्युनिकेट हो गया
दैट्स ऑल राइट
कलर इन लाइफ ये कौन है मैडम ये स्टूडेंट हैज सेड कलर इन लाइफ फॉर अ सेकंड इमेज
ओके
दैट कलरफुल वो फ्लावर था मेरे पास कलर इन लाइफ समबडी रोट
राइट लेट देम रिस्पोंड फर्स्ट एंड देन आई विल शो यू द ओरिजिनल इमेजेस
Hockey plus key.
Yes.
Hockey plus key. Somebody wrote.
Okay.
A student wrote hockey plus key. चलो चलो और बताओ. पास पास. चार पांच इमेज थी.
There were six only. So you
six
can,
images.
Yeah, you can just quickly drop your responses. You can communicate.
Rising sun.
Okay.
निकल गए मैडम फिर
ओके या लेट देम लेट मी स्टॉप शेयरिंग माई स्क्रीन
somebody wrote that somebody in Jaydev itself is writing that a image symbolizes PV Sindhu.
Okay. Close.
PV Sindhu ko symbolize kar raha hai ek image.
Okay.
जयदेव इज द वन हु इज रिस्पोंडिंग. बाकी लोग बच्चे लोग रिस्पोंड करो. मीराबाई चानू, आई मीन ओलंपिक्स है मैडम अभी सब बच्चों को. जयदेव इज क्वाइट फास्ट इनफ टू रिस्पोंड टू दिस न्यू टेस्ट ऑफ असामी करके कुछ है. दसाड़िया रियस दसाड़िया सेस यस मीराबाई चानू. That's it, ma'am. Even okay. Jadeja Pizza says Mirabai Chanu, PV Sindhu and all, they are responding the same.
Okay. Right. So, let me just open that that folder once again. And then I get back to you with my screen. Yeah. And let me tell you, sir, they were quite close to their answers. You can now check the original images, not this one. I'm sorry. So this one is saying what they were absolutely right about hockey and key.
Hockey and key.
Yeah, India got a hockey.
India got a hockey. Wow, let's play COD. Absolutely right. Very close.
Then this is Neeraj blossomed. Like you can see, is pure and then blossoming with golden flower.
Wow. Very close. Very close.
Yes, actually. Then this was absolutely right about Mirabai.
Wow.
And
get that point.
Yeah, 100% right. Well done, Sindhu.
They get the point. I mean, wow.
This is
Jadeja, yes, Brijraj, yes, and Jaydev, they get the point for this.
Yeah, this is about, again, right, new taste of Assam is, congratulations, Lovlina.
Wow.
This is a glove and then Assam ka chai.
Wow.
Yeah.
Madam.
this, I think nobody answered, probably, I'm not sure.
But
this is about girls hockey team.
Girls hockey team. Okay,
yeah,
this was representing
this is a girl hockey. And they are the hockey. The eyebrows are
okay.
So girls, you deserve a round of applause.
Eyelashes. Okay. Right.
This one is Ravi. The son is Ravi. Ravi Dahiya.
Ravi Dahiya. Okay.
Yeah.
So blossom tha, par ma'am lekar ke aaye the symbolically. Olympians ko lekar ke aaye the and definitely kuch log bahut isliye chanu anu tak wo people you know could have somehow relate ke somehow this is connecting to the stars which have recently been born and they have you know made us proud isliye Mirabai Chanu PV Sindhu and they all started coming. So nice thinking Jaydev, yes, and Uttam, Jaydev and Brij Raj, and let's play COD. Your name is that, so congratulations, round of applause.
True.
So they are moving, madam. Na, they are moving from communication to communication.
Yeah, absolutely.
Please, ma'am, continue.
Yeah. So I thought that should be some, you know, kind of ice break or fun in between this monotonous process of communication. So yeah, but it is a very significant. It has a very significant role to play in any setup, not only organizational, but it is must for organizational setup. Now. You all must have mugged up and crammed this figure by now. And I have duly acknowledged this source of this image. It is not the image that I have prepared. But from the exam point of view, you can remember that this is also known as communication cycle. It's a process of communication which is also in a circular motion. If you can see the direction of the arrows, you would feel that this is a cycle also, right? Now, before we enter this particular figure and discussion about this, let me share a few other things. Like all of us know that LSRW, listening, speaking, reading, and writing are the basic skills for any language learning, including English. Right? So all of us are by birth probably having listening and speaking skills. They get converted into skills when we are growing more and more. But basically, they are physical abilities. And reading and writing, we develop as our skills. So when we try to communicate, when we are trying to speak with somebody, it is always the activity of taking effort. Why there is a group of people who are excellent speakers, and why there are people who get cold feet when they are asked to opine on something. They are not supposed to speak on a stage. But right now, if I invite any one of you, how many of you would voluntarily say that, okay, ma'am, I want to speak for 5 minutes on a given topic? So I would be more than happy if there are more than 5 or 10 students. But it takes a lot of effort and courage, especially when you are in a junior semester. So these are the skills which allow you to communicate easily or in a better manner. My point here is, when I told you that somebody is asking me to enter my room and I'm just saying with my hand, or I'm just nodding my head in yes motion, it would take fraction of seconds for somebody to understand that yes, he or she is supposed to enter my room. And that will be the entire process of communication. This is what we are talking about, the fraction of seconds. But here, as you can see, it takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, or 10 things to understand how communication processes. And that is why probably it was selected as a topic for discussion, right? So remember this thing, that when we are actually performing communication, we do not pay much attention to our thinking. We do not spare much time on, okay, what would we do? Okay, I would, ma'am, aau kidu, okay, I should enter. Ma'am kai jawab nahi aapta, should I wait? Should I not wait? Should I wait? Should I not wait? So we don't, then you would ask second time, ma'am, may I come in? So we don't have that patience. We immediately ask for the second time. You would take it for granted that ma'am is not paying attention to me. She is busy with something. So you would ask for the second time. So my point is, the process that is shown here in figure, it takes time to remember. First of all, to draw, to remember, and then to reproduce. Whereas actual communication does not take so much of time. Now, let us go step by step. First component is obviously the sender, because he or she is the first party. I should be gender neutral. It should be sender who is sending you messages, who is sending you information, knowledge, idea, and trying to fill your katora, right? Now, the message, the concept, the idea, the knowledge that is being shared or sent by the sender, the first party, is in the form of encoded message. Now, what do we mean by the encoded message? When we say encoded, something is full of meaning. Some detail which has something hidden, like this. When it would be decoded, it would be open. It would be known to you. It would be accessible to you. So you can see that EN prefix is attached to the word coded, right? So it is encoded message which has some meaning, some information which the other party will have to understand or to learn, right? So once the message is ready, it will be sent. Look at the direction of the arrow. It will be sent. It will go to receiver. That is, now comes the second party in picture, the receiver, right? So you are the receiver right now, on the other hand, whom I am not able to even see. What were your expressions when you were uploaded with your right answers? Okay? So this is not communication, no communication is happening. I am looking at my PPT. You might be looking at me through YouTube channel where you are not able to communicate directly to me. So this is not the right way of communication, but somehow we are managing in this situation. So second party receiver is receiving message. Now, receiver and received message, there is this one word which is called channel. We are coming back to that. Keep it on a hold. But once you receive a message, once you saw the image, you would immediately try to work your mind, work your thoughts, ideas. Now, what does this mean? And sir was apprehensive that, oh, ma'am, today this Olympics is going on, so students are after that. They are under the impact of Olympics, even if it got over. But you were quite close in your thoughts, right? So you tried to decode, you tried to connect them with the image and with the current situation that is happening around or which has just ended. So you are trying to decode, understand or learn the meaning of what was sent by the sender, right? So if you are able to decode this, you will be able to respond. Now hold. I hope that decoding and encoding terms are clear because you must be watching so many movies and especially this time of relaxation or slack time in your studies, they must have given a lot of scope to see different types of movies or complete your wish list. Right? So you must be watching many defense related movies where you have this common dialogue that, oh, we are receiving some radio transmission from this border and that border and this sea. And there will be a team of people who will be decoding all these messages, okay? Encrypted messages. And the entire movie is all about that, like the movie called Thus 1010. Okay? So there was a lot of thinking on numbering that particular event. At the end, it's a different story at the end if you feel delay. But until the end, you would continuously thinking that what is happening? How would they reach to this code called 10, right? Okay, so you have decoded the message, there will be response. If you are able to decode it, there was a response. You responded that, okay, this is something with Mirabai, this is something to do with other PV Sindhu, right? And if there is a response, which I had expected, that is a sender had expected, this you again check the direction of the arrow. It is going back to the sender, and that will be known as feedback. If it is an expected response, it will be called feedback. Now, it's very easy to understand because in your exam, you are asked at times that what is feedback? Now, feedback is simple. It is a expected response. And so you can say that the responses are also governed, right? Now, if you go to a good hotel, before paying the bill, you would receive a page of feedback. There they would have these different questions. How was the food? How was the service? How was the ambience, right? And there will be either stars, which will start from first to five, or there will be good, average, best, everything like that. Even your online shopping platforms like Amazon, Flipkart, they are trying to improve day by day and they would have this feedback system. Even if you have query regarding your order and you drop a message or call the executive, immediately next after your putting off the call, they would send a link for the feedback, right? Was our executive helpful? Did he solve your problem? So and so. And once your package is received, again, there will be a feedback. If you want to return it, again, there will be a feedback that was it collected on time? Was the person kind enough? Right? So we are living in the life where we are full of feedbacks. Now, coming here to the channel. Channel is a medium. Something which connects, something which bridges two things. to give you an example, right now, internet is our channel. On a lighter note, Professor Srivastava was our channel because he tried to bridge this communication, this connection that I communicate to you and you through any medium communicate to the other teacher who is sitting 15 kilometers away in your city, right? So this is a channel, this is a medium which tries to combine two things and pass on the message. Right now, as I said, internet is our channel, the atmosphere is our channel. Right now, you can feel that there is not much sound around me. More or less, it is peaceful, right? So atmosphere is also helpful. Mobile network is also a channel because you have number of instances ke jahan tumhe ghar nahi bahar jaane ka awaaz nahi sambhala to, but why do you have to speak loud? Samne wala na awaaz nahi sambhala to emne mote thi bolvanu, tamare mote thi nahi bolvanu. So mobile network is also a channel, and the environment, ecological environment, is also our channel. Now, as we are speaking of channel, come here, the last line or the last sentence in this slide. Noise, which is highlighted, is crucial in communication, in any type of communication. Now, noise has connection with channel. Since channel is the link which allows you to speak or which allows you to express and respond, any noise in your mobile network, suppose right now I'm wearing this hands-free, and if there is a problem with my hands-free, there is a noise in my hands-free, communication won't happen, right? So tamne kaha ke ma'am tak bahut tadtadati aave, tamaro awaz sarkho nahi aavto, awaz break thai chhe, right? Now assume that there are lot many things happening around me, ki aap machine no awaz aave chhe, kai bijo class chale chhe, students bole chhe aju baju, so again there won't be a proper communication possible. So noise plays very crucial role in communication. And last but not the least, do not forget communication environment. Now when we say communication environment, this does not mean ecological environment. This environment means scope, opportunity, or place, not physical place, but opportunity or chance to communicate. Now for example, tumne ghani vakat tamara teachers evu keta hase that you don't have environment for English language around you. So they are not talking about ecological and English environment. To to apne ahiya bada Canada and America madhe jhadva chhe, bada jhadva chhe pine ne orchid ne antene bada, but they are talking about the environment that you should have, that when you speak, somebody should be there to respond back to you. Because in our environment cannot be built. So if I continuously speak like this and nobody is there to respond me, then I'm not speaking in Bengali or Malayali. So those of you who understand Gujarati, Hindi, English, they would be responding it, right? So communication environment means we need opportunity, we need these two parties, sender and receiver, who can communicate with common code of language and common code of symbols. So environment allows all these components to come together and then function in a proper manner to have effective communication at the end of the day. Yes. Now essentials of effect, I will not take much of the time. I know that we are nearing time, it is 4:45. I will take 5 to 7 more minutes. Yeah. Essentials of effective communication, this is more or less about the same slide, that it needs common communication environment. Like if I give you my personal example, when I say that I did not have English environment, whenever in the summer vacations or in other social or family gatherings, whenever we cousins used to meet, my all other cousins have studied in English medium schools or colleges. So whenever we used to meet, most of the time they would communicate in English, and I would feel the FOMO, your favorite word these days, right? Why? Because I didn't have this environment. My school was Gujarati medium. My friends were Gujarati medium students. My family is Gujarati. I was studying English. I started studying English from standard 5. So I didn't have communication environment for English. Right? So I used to wonder, I was actually flabbergasted whenever I meet them. And I felt shy always that, oh, they are able to speak and I'm not. So that is, it needs common communication environment to allow communication process to happen. Again, I'm taking the same example that if this, my hand movement, this, or my node like this, if it is not understood, if it is not decoded by the person who is coming, would he or she enter my room? No, because there is no common communication environment. The person does not understand what do I mean with this. Right? There should be cooperation between the sender and the receiver. Like sender, when he or she is sending or informing the message, there should be readiness that even if the receiver is receiving it in a distorted manner, let me have the distorted answer. And the receiver should not always expect ke mari ichha ke mane samjhay evi j rite hamesha message aave. Right now, if you have studied this chapter, it would be very easy and kind of revision for you. But if you are studying it for the first time, you might feel that hey, ma'am kato jhadap thi karave chhe. Kai khabar nat padti hai. It might happen. No offense taken. And it can happen with me also. Then there must be selection of an appropriate channel. Right now, if we are connected through internet, I must know that I should be having my laptop in front of me or computer in front of me because I want to show you a few images. I want to switch and shift my screen time and again. So I cannot just move around. I cannot walk in the lobby and teach you because it would create a disturbance. But if I'm just attending a meeting, I can move around. Or when I come to your campus, I might have to select a different channel. I would probably be using the chalk and board. I would probably be using some audio file. But right now, making too many things together, putting too many things together might make things messy. So because it's a distance thing, let me make it simple. Let me make it visual first. And then we may add a few things. Right? Then correct encoding and decoding of the message. The sender must attempt sincerely to send message in the best possible manner, as good as possible as the receiver can receive it smoothly. And at the same time, the receiver should also try that as much as possible, he or she should try to decode it and try to respond back to the sender. And finally, receipt of the desired response and feedback. It must reach back to the sender. And if it reaches, then and then, I know that the screen is changed, the slide is changed. I have gone back to my slide. The cycle gets over, right? If the cycle gets over, then and then only this entire communication process is completed. We were discussing about feedback. So when we are saying that cooperation, now what do we mean by cooperation? For example, if you are working in such an official setup where you are not even allowed to speak, or where your seniors do not give you opportunity to present your opinion, so you don't have any scope for feedback. Tamne wo khabar padhe chhe, you are feeling that, oh, there can be a better option for this situation, for this problem. But there is no scope for you to give a feedback. Or your sender, your superior, your senior is not ready, not cooperating to have your receipt on this matter. So that's why I said that even feedbacks are controlled. Right? So this is how, these are the essential points of effective communication. We need these many items to make our recipe of effective communication. These are the ingredients. And you can say these are the ingredients too. Now, 7 C's of communication, you would be able to see and learn all these things But there must be clarity in what you are sending and what you are trying to understand and respond back to your sender. So clarity of your message must be there. Right now, whatever I'm telling, I hope that it is clear. Clear, not in the sense of language. Language is also important, but clear in the sense conceptual clarity. મને એવી ખબર જ ન હોય કે સેન્ડર ને ચેનલ ને રિસીવર કેમ કામ કરે છે. See, there is a machine drawn here, and that's why I put this image here. Right? So machine smoothens things. Right? See, there are lot many things, skills, check mark. There is a media sign here. So this is the process that is happening every moment in our mind. Then there must be correctness. So when we communicate, there must be correctness, there must be correct details, factual details in what we are saying. Na samjhanu hoy to na paado, biji vakat pucho. Hun jare tamne communicate karu chu, mara thi vigat nathi pahochti, I should rectify my detail. Completeness. As much as possible, as far as possible, try to give complete view of the thing. Do not go for bits and bits. પછી તમે કહો કે લે હવે ક્યાર ને કહું છું પણ સમજતા જ નથી. બટ અહીંયાથી હું જમ્પ કરીને તરત પાછળ જતી રહું, પાછળના ફીડબેકમાંથી સીધી પાછી સેન્ડર ઉપર આવી જાઉં, there will be a problem. The message is not complete. Right? Then there should be concreteness. Means whatever I am sending, whatever arguments I am putting, there must be concrete example or concrete supplement ideas to that. હું એબસ્ટ્રેક્ટ એમ કહું કે હા કમ્યુનિકેશન છે ને આવી રીતે થાય, તમે સરખું બોલો એટલે બધું થઈ જ જાય. નો, ઇટ ડઝન્ટ હેપન ધેટ વે. હું મને ગુજરાતી બોલતા આવડે છે, આઈ એમ સ્પીકિંગ ગુજરાતી. વાય આર યુ નોટ એબલ ટુ સ્પીક અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડ? આઈ એમ સ્પીકિંગ ઇન ગુજરાતી, વાય ઇટ ઇઝ નોટ બીંગ કમ્યુનિકેટેડ? તમે કહેશે એ યાર આ શું બોલે, કઈ સમજાતું જ નથી. There are instances when this happened to us. Okay? So, because probably there is not concreteness, there is no clarity of thought, there must be conciseness. Jem bane em, it should be concise and crisp. Okay? It should not be unnecessarily lengthy. It need not be unnecessarily novel or drama kind of thing. You can do with short story or novella, I suppose. And nowadays it's a time of capsules or short films, teasers, right? Then there must be coherence. We should always go by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rather than 1, 5, 2, 3, 4, 9, right? So coherence is simply putting things in line, in arrangement. So there should be link between what we are saying, and courtesy. Never ever lose your courtesy. Even if it's a professional setup, if it's a social setup, any setup, your language must not lose its courtesy. Be it Gujarati, English, Hindi, any other language you know. Right? Because it was said by one of our teachers that courtesy costs nothing. Even if you have to say no with courtesy. Our teacher used to ask, that if you are saying no for some abstract acceptance, there was a conference and we were saying no to a few. So we were troubled. We were students then. So we were troubled and asked that, sir, like we have to say no to these people. They are senior teachers. How do we say no to them that your abstract is not accepted for presentation? The sir quoted this line then and he made us write that you are not accepted, but write that thanks, wishes and regards. So do not lose your courtesy. So these 7 C's I include, this might not be there in your any textbook or reference book, but I felt them to be important because they are complementing your process of communication. In professional setup, you must not forget any of these C's from your entire communication process or cycle, right? Because without them, any language, any process is not effective, right? Sir, do we have time or I should wind up?
We have time. You can continue. No issues.
Okay, sir.
No issues.
Yeah, okay. Yes. So again, this is too much basic for all of us. But let me quickly go to this. These are the characteristics that we should know. Exam point of view, it is fine, but we should know when we are specifically studying technical communication, because every now and then we are making general communication. So let us quickly check the differences. First, it contains a general message. Suppose when Sir joined us, he said that he was walking down to his room from somewhere on the campus, probably admin block. From admin block, probably to his chamber, to his room, he was walking. In the meantime, if he would have met any one of you, any two of you, he might have said that, "Arey, bete, there is this program at Yashwantrai today at night. You can just go and check if you are interested." Right? So that was a very general message, general communication. But on the other hand, if he would have met a third semester student, whom he knows that he or she is third semester student, he would say that today at 3:45 there is this talk on process of communication, which is part of your syllabus, so you must attend that. So that's a technical message, which he felt that it is meant for this semester, this year, this subject student, right? General message, general communication is informal in style and approach. It can be passed on probably through phone, probably when sir was walking down on the campus, probably when I met you somewhere in the market, I would say, "Hey, kaale evlo program che joi ledo jara, aajna chapa ma jahirat che." So that's very informal, right? But this technical message, as such, we have these terms of speaking on phone, right? I'm talking about me and your professor. But when this talk was about arranging a formal talk at your college under the name of online lecture series organized by the college, there was a formal invitation from sir, right? So it needs formal communication, formal technical communication, right? Then there is no set pattern in general communication. I need not inform you after asking our principal or after asking my parents that there is a program in Yashwantrai. Shall I inform the students? Shall I inform my friend? No, there is no set pattern. But to arrange this talk, this online lecture series, Professor Srivastava would certainly have discussed this with your principal, sir. Okay? Sir would have readily agreed. But Srivastava sir would have sounded it off that I am thinking of organizing this. These might be the speakers, and tentatively between these dates, we are planning. So there needs to have a pattern. There might not be requirement of a signed document, but at least sir would have informed it. So that's a set pattern that a faculty is informing to the higher authority or principal. Then general communication happens mostly in oral format, whereas technical communication can happen in oral manner as well as in written manner. Okay? My principal sir, even your principal sir, might have agreed that, "Yes sir, you go ahead with this lecture series." And when sir might have sent the invitation letter or the certificate, principal sir would have signed in on hard copy. So that's a written communication that, yes, he agrees for this invitation. Right? So that's oral as well as written communication. Fifth, general communication does not always mean for a specific audience. I can inform about an event in Yashwantrai to you, to my students, my colleague, my friends, my relatives at my place in Jamnagar, Ahmedabad, wherever, right? But at the same time, technical communication is always meant for specific audience. These days, there are series of webinars happening here and there. You must also be attending a few. So a few would be meant for specific branch students. A few would be meant for specific year students, for specific branch, for specific interest people, and a few would be very general. Everybody can enjoy, and you all are free to join and then comment. So that's very general. So we are not saying that general communication is derogatory or it is not important, but general communication is not a watertight compartment. It can flow freely as a normal routine activity. Like right now, probably right, not right now, but like we meet on your campus and we just meet, ma'am, yes, I had attended your talk. And we then start speaking and then we might have a bond, right? And last point, general communication does not involve the use of technical vocabulary or graphics, etc. I can just say that aapne chapu joy le jo. Aajna chapa ma column number so and so, written by so and so, evo lakhani jarur nathi. But in technical communication, it often requires jargon, graphics, like you, if you are presenting, like your invite, it reads that online lecture series phase 2. So it's a jargon that it's a lecture series. It's not a talk. Right? I'm lecturing you. There is a difference between talk and lecture because talk might be a bit informal at times. Right? So it needs the introduction or the photo of the speaker. It needs to have some kind of registration or invite link. It needs time, venue, and date. Right now, we need not have venue. But the platform, Google Meet or Microsoft Teams, it's a kind of venue. Right? So these are the basic differences or key differences between general and technical communication. I think I would leave some scope for question and answer. I would not like to stretch more than this. But these are the levels of communication, which are 5 basically: extrapersonal, intrapersonal, interpersonal, organizational, and mass. Which again, some other faculty or your teachers in class would discuss. These are the barriers to this communication. And for the semester 3 students who must have joined, after this, you would be learning nonverbal communication as a significant topic for which I'm sure sir must have arranged some other expert speaker, right? These are a few links where you can access. This is about, you know, a few very common questions that youth or the young speakers you might have. See, voice of youth. Then these 2 videos are by your favorite public speaker. I know because my students keep referring to him. So I suppose, and I take it for granted that generally it is for all. Sandeep Maheshwari. One is about effective communication skills. And in another, he is talking about how to be a confident speaker in English. So that's why I have put this link here. You can refer it to that. And last video is, or last link is about NPTEL videos on communication skills, which is, and this link is covering so many videos of so many components about communication skills aspect that I suppose if you go through them once and make notes, they would certainly be supplementary to your regular class studies. Now, again, I am also trying to govern your, my feedback that yes, there should be a feedback. I wish you all the best. And I would certainly expect your feedback if now or at a later stage. But now I would stop my screen sharing.
The students have started. The students have started. Ma'am, the students have started overwhelming response. Really enjoying. We are really enjoying the session. Very, very nice session. Lively session. Nice way to start the session. Ma'am, it was excellent. Thank you, ma'am. Mera bhi naam likh lo, bachcho. Thank you, Himanshu sir.
It was just a joke apart. Governed feedback should not be there. I am open to have any criticism or any suggestion also. And I would be more than happy if there are any questions. Sir, please.
Right now we don't have any questions. Ma'am, we have made this live. And this is available to us. The students who are right now in the session, when they are free, after 6 o'clock, they will be going through it. And they will be posting their questions to me on my WhatsApp.
Sure.
Forwarding it to you. Right?
For sure.
So by tomorrow, probably, we will be completing this cycle. This is a cycle of actually 24 hours. Okay. By tomorrow, it will. Thank you, Srivastava sir. Thank you, ma'am. We are really enjoying the session. Ha, ho gaya, beta, complete ho gaya session. Sir is about to join. He has just given me a call. Ma'am,
yes.
Audi, ma'am, you continue. I'll be just giving a call to sir. Thank you, sir, for arranging such a wonderful lecture for us. Arre, wa, thank you, beta. waiting for future lectures. Informative session, ma'am.
Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Ma'am, youth festival in charge hai. So, ma'am, mere se bhi zyada afsani bachche hai. Engineering college, always involved with students. So she knows the psyche of the students, and you can easily, you know, easily in her way of communicating the topic itself. This is a topic we kya khub liya tha. Communication. Chaliye madam, Audi ma'am, your words, I would be giving a call to sir, because sir has just said that give me a call when it is about. Audi ma'am.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
I'll just keep myself on
mute. Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much, Shudhani madam. And your session was actually so student friendly. And the 2 points I would like to draw. One is whenever the teacher uses her own self for any sort of examples or illustration, it carries a special significance for the students also. And you did it excellently throughout your session. So very good for that. And secondly, it was really so innovative, madam, to draw our students towards our Olympian winners through this symbolic images. It was really, really so, so innovative idea. And even I noticed that the first one or two images were arranged, in chronological order also. So that one by one, the students come to recognize the names of the Olympian. And the last one, that Ravi Dahiya, that was a bit difficult. But once you have the switch that all images are related to representing the Olympians, then the sun may represent Ravi. That is not the images and the sequencing of the images.
Good evening, sir. Has joined us. He was telling me that the moment you are about to end the lecture, I won't disturb in the middle of the session. So I was just waiting for the session to be over. Sir, Dhwani ma'am from Sandilal Shah Engineering College, a very fabulous session on process of communication, all the ways how to communicate effectively. She has directed to the students. Your kind words.
Wonderful. Thank you, Dhwani madam, for your wonderful lecture, process of communication. And as been narrated by Dr. Srivastava, I'm sure all students must have enjoyed your very enlightening lecture. So thank you very much, madam.
Thank you very much.
She like me is handling finishing school, youth festival, and many more things into students of Shantilal Shaw Engineering College.
And yes, exactly, sir. I would like to add that we are happy to have you in Bhavnagar.
Oh, thank you, madam. Thank you. Let's see. Let's work together, all of us.
Yes, sir.
And all our Bhavnagar students are much, much benefited from what we are and what we are having. And we want to give 100% for the students. We want that students get benefited from our efforts and they become a very good engineer, smart engineer. They get a good salary at the end of the day. And they become the responsible citizen of India. That's what, at the end of the day, this is what I want expect from the students. Yeah. So thank you, madam.
Thank you very much, sir. After LD, it has been...
Students have started commenting. We are lucky to have you as a principal here on the live chat.
Thank you.
But no, because we have seen sir running around and managing so many things at LD College during our youth festival time. So that's why I specifically said that it is... We are happy to have you here.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
And I am working with the same spirit and energy with all of us.
I am also lucky that I got a chance to work in GC Bhavnagar, where I could even work with more force and energy, because compared to LD, it's a very small institution. I can spare more time and I can have more activity because the number of students and faculty are very less in number compared to LD. So I can have more and more development of the institution. I hope that within a couple of years, this will be as good as LD or any other good institution or state.
Yes, sir.
I want that my faculty members become the base faculty of Gujarat. They win some even awards from the state level, national level, and our students become the best NSS volunteer or best student. Academic gold medal comes to G Bhavnagar, maybe a GC or Santilal. I want it to come to Bhavnagar. Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you all. Thank you, principal, sir. Thank you, Dhwani, ma'am.
Before leaving, final word of thanks to you and Ahuti, ma'am. Of course, first, official thanks goes to Gurudarya sir for generating this opportunity and supporting this initiative. And of course, even if we are in on friendly terms, but it requires a lot of efforts, I know. So I thank Srivastav sir and Ahuti ma'am also. I thank all the students for their generous feedback. I hope that you meant what you were communicating. And the team, yes, who is working on social media for sharing it live. Yes, media team. And I would also thank my colleagues, because Ahuti ma'am specifically said, and there were a few responses also, that the beginning was a bit different with this Olympic images. So I would thank one of my colleagues, Professor Alpesh Pandya, for sharing this idea. I had the images, but then it was a discussion, and then suddenly it came to us. I thank
for
him
a program
also.
For a program like this, you know, I have always my media club and the president ready with me, my team and all. This is the president of media club who is sharing all these things live. Great. The round of applause for this girl. Thank you. Thanks, sir.
I thank you very much. All of you.
We'll call it a day. And yes, sir.
Srivastava sir, I think I'm sorry to interrupt you, but I think we have talked about the life learning lessons from Olympic winners. We have to arrange one seminar.
Yes, sir, it is. It is there next week.
Okay, okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Tomorrow, thank you. Once again, students, we are once again live at 4:30 to 5:30. A teacher from LD is going to come to teach you all. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Ahuti ma'am, Media Club, Principal sir, and to all the students. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.